Hi, welcome to Lachlan Likes a Thing, a show where I take a thing and see whether or not I like it. Now, the thing we're looking at in this video is the new backlit touch cover 2 for Microsoft Surface and Surface Pro tablets. In this video, I'm going to give you some comments about the design and the usability of the new touch cover 2 compared to the old touch cover 1 and the old type cover. Also in this video, I'm going to show you my performance on some typing tests just to give you a general idea of what the accuracy is on the new touch cover 2 compared to the old keyboards. Anyway, let's have a closer look. Now, I have really mixed feelings about the original touch cover, and here it is attached to my Surface Pro. One thing I really like about the original touch cover is that because it's much thinner than the type cover, when you fold it over on the Surface, it's much more flush with the top of the Surface. It feels more like a part of the tablet. The other nice thing about the touch cover is that when you fold it backwards to use the Surface like a tablet, your fingers aren't pressing down on the keyboard keys. There's just a flat surface. It feels much more grippy and more secure. The other thing I really like about the touch cover is that it's actually spill resistant. So, if you're going around brushing your teeth while using your Surface, you don't have to worry about water messing up all the keys. Unfortunately, I found that the original touch cover was just not very accurate for typing, and I found that I really couldn't type on it for very long because all the typos would really annoy me. Now, this is the new touch cover 2, and I got one of these because apparently it has everything that I like about the original touch cover, while at the same time, Microsoft claims that they were able to dramatically improve the accuracy of the typing performance on the touch cover 2 by dramatically increasing the number of sensors throughout the keyboard. They also added a backlight to the touch cover 2, which is a really, really nice addition. And at the same time, they've also made the touch cover 2 slightly thinner than the original touch cover, and they've even made it slightly lighter than the original touch cover. And it's not a huge difference, but because the Surface Pro is already such a bulky tablet, every little bit counts. Now, before I get into what typing is like on the new touch cover 2, there was one small physical difference that I wanted to point out between the old touch cover and the new touch cover. Now, on the old touch cover, on the folding mechanism, there's actually a second band right in the middle here between the docking part and the keyboard, which adds a bit of strength and rigidity to the folding mechanism. Now, they've actually removed that section on the touch cover 2. You see that that's completely blank, so it's a little less rigid than the old touch cover design. Now, I only noticed this because I'm a lazy person and I like to use the Surface Pro lying down a lot. And even though Microsoft probably wouldn't recommend this, when I'm lying down, I sometimes use the keyboard just to prop up the weight of the Surface Pro just a little. And this is something that I really wouldn't encourage you doing on the new touch cover, because with the lack of that internal support here, you can actually see that the cover actually folds a lot more along that area. And it's not very rigid, and I think it would really damage the cover over the long term. Now, I'm gonna show you some typing tests, and then I'm gonna give you my conclusion about what typing is like on the new touch cover 2. Now, I'm just using a free typing test that I found over at 10fastfingers.com. This is not gonna be a scientific test because it's not real world typing, but I'm gonna give you average results over 3 runs compared to the original keyboards, and then maybe you can get an idea of what the accuracy improvements are like on the new touch cover 2. Now, again, that was not a scientific test in any way, shape, or form. And in the real world, if you were making a whole bunch of typing errors like I was, you'd probably slow down and kind of check what you were doing. But what the results seem to suggest is that I'm not really doing any better on the new touch cover 2 than I am on the original touch cover. And, what the results seem to indicate is that maybe I'm actually doing a little bit worse on the new touch cover 2. Now, I would take that result with a grain of salt. My general impressions using the touch cover 2 over the past few days is that it feels a bit more accurate, a bit more sensitive than the original touch cover. But unfortunately, it's still not nearly as good to type on as the type cover. And that's number one because I don't really get a good sense of where my fingers are on the keys at all times. The other issue is that I still don't think it works very well at all when you're trying to use this on any surface that's not just a flat desk. And another issue I find with the touch covers is that because they're a little inaccurate, I find myself unconsciously typing the keys harder. And because there's no key travel, my fingers actually start getting a bit sore after a bit of typing. So unfortunately, I'm not really enjoying typing on the new Touch Cover 2, and I'm gonna have to go to the store and exchange this for one of the new Type Covers to get that awesome backlight. Anyway, please click the like button if this video helped you. I'm probably gonna make another video comparing the new Type Cover 2 to the original Type Cover, so subscribe to my channel if you wanna be notified when that's up. Thanks to everyone who's liked my other videos and subscribed to my channel. You can talk to me on Twitter at @LachlanLikesAThing, or you can talk to me on Facebook at facebook.com/LachlanLikesAThing. Anyway, enjoy the rest of your week.